Tom and Mandy here, and they're hosting me in Venice at their beautiful home, and they are so wonderful to stay with. You know, Zack, they might be the reason I come to town from here on out. Anyway, we're going to do a number right here. This is a blues number that Walter recorded that's pretty heavy. This is one called Blue and Lonesome.
Thank you.
bass player. He's one of the best in the world at the blues. I'm telling you. This is Bill Stuve on the bass. Take it a little bit.
How about give yourself a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for coming out here. How about a hand, for Ed, our sound man over here. And Cadillac Zack for keeping this stuff up. I know he's going to pay me now tonight, so if I say it, he likes to hear his name. Z-A-C.
Give it to Doug.
Here's a Muddy Waters song, but Little Walter played on it. Not a lot of people play this one, but we do, and hope you enjoy it. Got to find my baby. A one, two, a one, two, three. Oh,
back there. All right, we're going to do another, this is one of the later Walter ones, but it's a great song. This is one called One of These Mornings.
Here we go on the kid
beat. That's a good thing to know.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Now we're going to do this number. This is one of my... I've been captivated by this song since I first heard it. You know, the funny thing about Little Walter, you know, people are always...
What was that?
I hope it's not my amp. I was just going to discuss amplifiers, and then it does that. No, you know, the funny thing about Little Walter, when I first heard a lot of those recordings, I went, what amp is he playing through? Why it's doing that? And then I, must be Little Walter speaking from the dead.
He's here.
But, you know, he never had an amp. He basically played through whatever was there. He is speaking to me. I better shut the hell up.
Can I do a little thing on Shaky J?
Yeah.
Okay, I got 5 90-minute interviews with Shaky J. Because out of all the whole bunch, you get about 5 different stories from each guy, but Shaky J always stayed put. So I asked him, I go, what amp did Little Walter play through? And he goes, most of the time, no amp. But he would watch the other bands playing, and at the clubs in Chicago, they had these tiny little metal speakers all over the wall. So there was 21 of them, he said. And the master amp on the top of the piano that you see there was hooked to all those speakers, and he realized a singer could be heard everywhere perfect. So that's what he played through.
And I heard that from Dave Myers, too. He said the same thing. Yeah,
really?
Hanging on the walls, yeah.
Oh.
I hope all you harp players were paying attention to that.
Yeah. It is rocker.
All right, here's rocker.
I'm solid state, man.